Cool. Okay. All right. Website updates. So,
as you transition through the phases of we start to open, we are now adding video. Now this is our new normal, second half of 2020. 5 different areas of your website to keep coming back to over and over. Each step of those transitions, run through this little checklist, make sure that your website is updated based on what phase of transition you're in right now. The first is your value proposition and your messaging. And this doesn't have to be a complete rewrite of your whole website. If your website is still very on brand to your mission and your core values and who you help with what, you don't need to rewrite your whole website, but see if there's some headlines that you can tweak. See if your navigation needs a tweak. If you need to move some pages in and out of it, change a couple of your headlines. Is my current value proposition right now, is that reflected in the messaging on my website? The second is your intro offers and your pricing page. This might be something that there's going to be a couple different phases of your pricing here. You don't have to make your old pricing model work right now. You can change your pricing. This might be an opportunity to change your pricing. You're going to add, if this is something you're doing, you're going to add an online classes or a virtual studio, whatever you call it, navigation item to the main navigation at the top of your website. So you have studio classes, you have online classes. It is now a pillar of the services, the offers that you have. It took this collective community, I know the mind-body community, a little bit of time to wrap our heads around the difference between live stream and on demand. Those aren't terms that the average person knows what they are instantaneously. So you need to describe that to them. You need to separate those out and doing it on separate pages. Mention the pricing for each one. Mention when the prices can link between the two. Have the different schedules. If you have like an online streaming page, have those classes separate from the in-studio pages, at least while everything, we're in this messy middle and you don't know where the new normal is. But you should always have, if you have an online only offer, you should have a page for that separate from your other stuff. And if you can, give a teaser of what that actually looks like. A demo reel, a screenshot of the course platform that you're using so that people know, can see tangibly what they're buying as well as read about what it is. Syncing up your call to action buttons. Remember, this is kind of the checklist you're just going to go through every time you hit another phase of reopening and your new normal. Check where your buttons are leading people to. Buttons, like I said, headlines earlier, I mentioned that on number one, and button text are the two things that kind of go hand in hand whenever you're changing what you want people to do on your website. The in-between text, a lot of people are going to skip over anyway, but make sure the headlines and the buttons are very clear about the next step that you want them to take. And then update your thank you page. This is one that gets missed a lot, but a lot of you have thank you pages, especially if you're using branded web and you're taking advantage of that thank you page on your website, which I recommend everyone does. Make sure that if you're processing, and this is for the mind-body folks, but for whatever platform you're on, if you have a thank you page that happens when someone completes a transaction, make sure it gives the right information.
There you go. Okay, homework. So quick things, run through this list, update your website. This is a pretty fast list. You guys could probably get that done today or by the end of the week. Define your virtual studio platform. So write out, what is my virtual studio going to look like? And then define that platform. Again, we're trying to make this decision now. It's flexible, you can change it, but we're trying to do it now so that when you're opening back up, you're not trying to balance this with getting people used to what it looks like to be physically back in the studio and stuff again. Familiarize yourself with the platform. Any tool that you have, MindBody is a great example of this, but any of the platforms you guys are using, how much you like it is directly proportionate to how much you understand it. So whatever platform you go with, like, know how it works, know the ins and outs, practice on it, get familiar with it, create your search and your standard operating procedures around it as well. Create an SOP for your staff as a result. So if your staff are going to have to be involved in it, you need to have an SOP for them. It doesn't have to be hyper detailed at this point, but just quick things. To be able to do this with a video, you go here, you log in there, you do this, you do that. So you just go through that process. And then the final thing would be to create a troubleshooting guide for your clients. If you're going to be launching on a platform, let's say you're using the one that we showed on Maria's site, what happens if they can't log in or something else? If you just create a troubleshooting guide, can't log in, click the link here to reinitiate your username. Whatever, like, think about those questions and it'll grow over time. But it's virtual, so build that stuff virtually as well so that even if someone emails you, you can just send them to the sort of help suite around it so that it's not a lot of lifting on your side. Those would be the quick things for us to sort of get dialed in. This was all super exciting to you and you think it's valuable and you know someone else in the yoga community who needs this information, send them over to the Yogapreneur Collective. We have a lot of people who are reaching out for help, and sometimes they just need a little bit of enthusiasm to hear that this is a good place for them to be. So tell them to come and join and get in on these webinars, and so we can help them come out of this on top, just like you guys are going to be. All right. We will talk again soon. Peace.